गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट स्कीम एंड गवर्नमेंट इनिशिएटिव्स 2019 and 20. सो लेट डिस्कस अबाउट इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक्स दैट्स रिलेटेड फॉर योर यूपीएससी प्रीलिम्स एंड मेंस एज वेल एज फर्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज नेशनल पेंशन स्कीम फॉर ट्रेडर्स एंड सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयड पर्सन. इट इज ए पेंशन स्कीम फॉर द व्यापारी, रिटेलर, शॉपकीपर, सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयड पर्सन विथ एनुअल टर्नओवर नॉट एक्सीडिंग 1.5 करोड़. इट इज ए वॉलेंट्री एंड कंट्रीब्यूटरी पेंशन स्कीम. एनरोलमेंट अंडर द स्कीम इज फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट फॉर द बेनिफिशरी. एनरोलमेंट इज बेस्ड अपॉन सेल्फ सर्टिफिकेशन. इट इज ए प्रोविजन फॉर मिनिमम एश्योर्ड पेंशन 3,000 मंथली ऑन अटेनिंग द एज ऑफ 60 ईयर्स. सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट सेल गिव 50% शेयर ऑफ द मंथली कंट्रीब्यूशन एंड रिमेनिंग 50% कंट्रीब्यूशन सेल बी मेड बाय द बेनिफिशरी. एलिजिबिलिटी, बेनिफिशरी इज रिक्वायर्ड टू हैव एन आधार कार्ड and saving bank or Jan Dhan account passbook only. He or she should be within 18 to 40 years of age group. GSTIN is required only for those with turnover 40 lakh above. The beneficiary should not be income tax payer and also not a member of EPFO, ESIC और NPS, PMSYM. Second topic that is International Financial Service Center Authority Bill 2019. What is International Financial Service Center Authority? IFSC enables bringing back the financial services and transaction that are currently carried out in offshore financial center by the Indian corporate entities and overseas branches, subsidiaries of financial institution to India by offering business or regulatory environment that is comparable to other leading international financial center in the world like London and Singapore. It would provide Indian corporate easier access to global financial market. What are the service an IFSC can provide? Fundraising services for individual, corporation and government, asset management and global portfolio in diversification undertaken by the pension fund, insurance company and mutual funds, wealth management. Fourth, global tax management, cross-border tax liability optimization, which provides a business opportunity for financial intermediaries, accountants, and law firms. So on. The bill seeks to set up an authority, the International Financial Service Center Authority. Management of the authority consisting of chairperson, one member each of the nominated of by the Reserve Bank of India, SEBI, IRDAI, PFRDA, so on. Function of the authority, regulate all such financial services, financial product, and FIS is an IFSC which has already been permitted by the financial sector regulator for IFSCs. Regulate such other financial product, financial services or FIS may be notified by the central government from time to time. Recommend to central government such other financial product, financial services, financial institution which may be permitted in IFSCs. Who is covered? The bill will be applicable to the all international financial services center under the Special Economic Zones Act 2005. The first IFSC in India has been set up at the Gujarat International Finance Tech City, Gift City in Gandhinagar. Third topic, that is Partial Credit Guarantee Scheme. Partial Credit Guarantee Scheme for NBFCs gets cabinet nod. Key features of the scheme: it allows for purchase of high rated pools assets from financial sound non-banking financial companies and housing finances companies by public sector. The scheme would cover NBFCs, HFCs that might have slipped into the special mention account SMA0 category during the 1 year period prior to August 2018, and asset pools related
BBB plus
or higher. The window for one-time partial credit guarantee offered by the government would remain open till June 30, 2020 or till such date by which 1 lakh crore worth of asset get purchased by the banks, whichever is earlier. Finance Minister would have the power to extend the validity of the scheme by up to the 3 months by taking into the accounts its progress. Special Mention Account SMA. Classification of Special Mention Account was introduced by the RBI in 2014 to identify those accounts that has potential to become NPA or stressed asset. Special Mention Account are those asset or accounts that show symptoms of bad asset quality in the first 19 days itself. Special mention accounts are usually categorized in the terms of duration, SMANF, non-financial signals of stress, SMA0, principal or interest payment not overdue for more than 30 days, but account showing sign of incipient asset stress, SMA1. Principal or interest payment overdue between 31 to 60 days, SMA2. Principal or interest payment overdue between 61 to 19 days. Now next topic, that is e-bikri, e-edu auction portal. E-bikri, e-auction portal. Union Finance Minister has recently launched the e-bikri, e-auction portal, objective to enable online auction by banks of attached assets transparently and cleanly for the improved realization of the value. Key feature: it is a framework for promoting online auction of asset attached by the banks. It is equipped with the property search feature and contain navigational links to all the public sector banks e-auction sites. The framework aims to provide single window access to information on properties. Next topic, that is Sovereign Gold Bond Scheme. Government of India, in the consultation with the RBI, has decided to issue sovereign gold bonds. The bonds will be sold through scheduled commercial banks, except small financial banks and payment banks, Stockholding Corporation of India Limited, designated post offices, recognized stock exchanges like National Stock Exchange of India, Limited and Bombay Stock Exchange Limited. About the Sovereign Gold Bond Scheme, the Sovereign Gold Bond was introduced by the government in 2015. Government introduced these bonds to help to reduce the India's over dependence on the gold imports. Third, the move was also aimed at changing the habits of Indians from saving in physical form of gold to a paper form with the sovereign backing. Key facts: eligibility. The bond will be restricted for sale to resident Indian entities, including individual HUFs, trust, universities and charitable institution, denomination and tenor. The bond will be denominated in the multiple of grams of gold with the basic unit of 1 gram. The tenure will be a period of 8 years with exit option from the 5th year to be exercised on the interest payment dates. Minimum and maximum limit. The minimum permissible investment limit will be 1 gram of gold, while the maximum limit will be 4 kg for the individual, 4 kg for the half HUF, and 20 kg for the trust and similar entities per fiscal April to March, notified by the government from time to time. Joint holder. In the case of joint holding, the investment limiting will be 4 kg for the first applicant only. Collateral. Bonds will be used as a collateral for loans. The loan to value ratio is to be set equal to the ordinary gold loan mandate by the Reserve Bank from time to time. Tenure. The tenure of the bond will be for period of 8 years with exit option after the 5 year to be exercised on the interest payment dates. Interest rate. The investor will be compensated at the fixed rate of 2.5% per annum, payable semi-annually on the nominal value. Next topic, that is BHIM 2.0. Government launches BHIM 2.0 with the new function and additional language support. What is BHIM? Bharat Interface for Money is a UPI based payment interface developed by National Payment Corporation of India, NPCI, allow real-time fund transfer, launched in 2016 December. What's the new BHIM 2.0? Donation gateway, increased transaction limit for high value transaction, linking multiple bank accounts, offer such for merchant, option applying in IPO, gifting money. It also support 3 additional language, Konkani, Bhojpuri and Haryanvi, over the above the existing 13. What is the UPI? Unified Payment Interface is a system that powers multiple banks accounts into the single mobile application, merging several banking features, seamless fund routing and merchant payment into one hood. It also caters the peer-to-peer collect request, which can be scheduled and paid as per the requirement and convenience. Each bank provides its one UPI app for Android, Windows or iOS mobile platform. About NPCI. NPCI is a umbrella organization for operating retail payments and settlement system in India. It is an initiative of RBI and Indian Banks Association under the provision of Payment and Settlement System Act 2007 for creating a robust payment and settlement infrastructure in India. It has been incorporated as a not-profit company in 2016. The shareholding was broad-based to 56 member banks to include more banks representative to all sector. Next topic, that is Enterprise Development Center, EDCs. Union Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises Sector, MSME, Ministry is planning to launch Enterprise Development Centers in every district. What are the EDC aimed at? Developing a cadre of indigenous entrepreneurs in the MSME. EDC will be similar to the incubator for startup. They shall be run by a special purpose vehicle in partnership with the private sector, business management organization and local industry association. Key feature, roles and function of EDs: offers enterprise development courses, enterprise clinics, credit facilitation, syndication, export promotion and supplier inclusion, incentivize and loans by the government for the sector. Next topic, that is NIRVIC scheme, Export Credit Guarantee Corporation of India, ECGC, announced this scheme to ease the lending process and enhance the loan availability for the exporter. Key features of the scheme: insurance cover will cover up to 19% of principal and interest. Increased cover will be ensured that foreign and rupee export credit interest rate are below 4% and 8% respectively for the exporter. The insurance cover will include both pre and post shipment credit. Gems, jewelry, diamond sector borrower with limit over 80 crore will have the higher premium rate in comparison to the non-JGD sector borrowers of this category due to the higher loss ratio. Benefit of the scheme: it will enhance accessibility and affordability of the credit for the exporter. It will help make the Indian export competitive. It will make ECGC procedure export friendly. Next, government e-market, GeM. GeM is a state-of-the-art national public procurement platform of Ministry of Commerce and Industries that has used technology to remove entry barrier for bona fide sellers and has created a vibrant e-marketplace with a wide range of goods and services. GeM facilities listing the product of individuals, prescribed categories of goods, service of common use, look, estimate, compare and buying facility of dynamic price basing, marketplace buying of majority of the common user items, buying goods and services online whenever required, transparency, ease of buying, useful for low value buying and bulk buying at competitive price using reserve auction, e-bidding, continuous vendor rating system, return policy, who can buy, who can purchase through the GeM. All central government and state government ministries, department including its attached or subordinate offices, central and state autonomous bodies, central and state public sector units and local bodies are authorized to make procurement through GeM portal. Who can sell on GeM? Sellers on GeM will be OEMs, original equipment manufacturer, or their authorized channel partner, reseller, dealership of OEM to sell their product in the open market or e-marketplace. Next topic, नेशनल एग्रीकल्चर मार्केट ई नेम नेशनल एग्रीकल्चर मार्केट इज़ एन ऑनलाइन ट्रेडिंग प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर एग्रीकल्चर प्रोड्यूस एमिंग टू हेल्प फार्मर्स ट्रेडर्स एंड बायर्स विद ऑनलाइन ट्रेडिंग एंड गेटिंग ए बेटर प्राइस बाय स्मूथ मार्केटिंग. इट वॉज लॉन्च बाय द सेंटर इन 2015 एंड द गवर्नमेंट हैड टू एक्सटेंड इट in a phased manner across the 585 mandis of the country by December 2019. The portal is managed by Small Farmer Agri Business Consortium SAFEC. On the e-name platform, farmers can opt to trade directly onto their one through mobile app or through registered commission agents. Name has the following advantages for the farmers. Name promises more option for sale. It would increase his access to market through the warehouse best sales and thus obvious the need to transport his produce to the mandi. For the local trader in the mandi market, name offers the opportunity to access a larger national market for secondary trading. Bulk buyers, processor, exporter, etc. benefit for being able to participate directly in trading at a local mandi market level through the name platform, thereby reducing their intermediation cost. The gradual integration of the all major mandis in the state into the name will ensure the common procedure for issue of license, levy of fee and movement of produce. The NAM will also facilitate the emergence of the value chain in the major agriculture commodities across the country and help to promote the scientific storage and the movement of agri goods. Thanks for watching this video, friends. In this video we will discuss almost 10 important topics related to economic for your competitive exam. That is very, very important for UPSC also. So listen and watching this video, you will analyze yourself. Yes, I got something new. Spread my channel across the world. Thanks a lot.